This is a Tuxedo Infinity Book 14, which was kindly provided to me by Tuxedo themselves. I have to say I was quite looking forward to this review because I was already searching for a MacBook Air 2011 replacement, and this thing comes really close to that. The touchpad is great, the keyboard is great, the full HD screen is great, camera, yeah, it's medium, but it does its job for video calls and stuff like that. Let's actually get started with looking around at the ports and everything, and I'll talk about the software and the hardware later. On the right side we can find a microSD slot, headphone jack, HDMI, USB 3, USB-C, which is really nice because this thing is going to be future-proof for at least a few years from now on. Charging port, by the way, you can even charge the notebook from the USB-C port, which I tried with a Nintendo Switch adapter, and it actually worked to charge the notebook almost as fast as the included charger. On the left side we have two USB 2 ports, nothing on the back side, nothing on the front side, and on the bottom you just get the normal writing and everything, so there's nothing interesting there. When we open up the Infinity Book 14 we can find the touchpad, which is an all-in-one touchpad, which I'm kinda not a fan of, but it's not just the Infinity Book. Actually, the Infinity Book 14 does a great job of implementing the touchpad, these all-in-one touchpads, I mean, because I'm still used to these physically split apart touchpads where you have the buttons on the bottom and the little plastic square on the top, and it just feels a little bit nicer and more accurate. But the Infinity Book 14 does a great job for what it has, and the all-in-one touchpad it does feature is actually great. So no real complaints there, other than my opinion being that I just don't like all-in-one touchpads in general. You can set a few gestures if you're on a Windows 10. This thing comes pre-installed with Linux. I'll get into that later a little bit. But I've installed Windows 10 and I've been quite happy using it with Windows 10, and you can use gestures and configure a lot of stuff with the touchpad, like a two-finger touch gestures, a three-finger touch gestures, and stuff like that. So it's great for what it is. Not a fan of all-in-one touchpads, but it's implementing what it has in a really great way. After the touchpad comes the keyboard, probably one of the most important features on a notebook, of course. And I have to say, the keyboard is really nicely done here, so the typing feel is probably one of the best ones I've used in a notebook so far, at least better than on any Lenovo, HP, Dell laptops I've been using so far. The only complaint I have about it is that they've used a little bit of a weird plastic for this. I'm used to the smooth plastic they use for keys, but this is a little bit, it feels a little bit rough. It's hard to describe on video. You probably have to type on this keyboard yourself to kind of get a feel for it. But when I first got this laptop, I had a little bit of longer nails, and I was typing on this thing, and it was really annoying because it always felt like you were typing on sandpaper, on a really fine grit sandpaper. You'll have to type yourself to really feel what I mean here. It's not bad once you have cut nails here, like I do now. It really is a nice keyboard, and the type feel is great. So to summarize this thing, keyboard feeling is great, plastic used not so much. The next important thing on a notebook is of course the screen, and I have to say I've never used a better display than on the Tuxedo Infinity Book 14. This thing has a full HD matte finish screen, and the viewing angles are also great. You can tilt it like this, you can tilt it completely back or completely to yourself, I'd still be able to see all the colors like they should be. And you can also view it from right and left, of course, and it's just almost perfect. So there are no complaints there, no screen tearing whatsoever, at least what I've noticed so far. Just great, I have no complaints there. On the right hand side we have two little LEDs which show the current status of the laptop itself. On the right hand side we have a power LED which will actually come on if you press the power button, of course. And on the left side we have a little charging indicator. And on the top side we have a little camera here with a camera LED which will actually turn on when you're using the camera, and stereo microphones. At least it looks like stereo microphones, I haven't actually tested that. So let's actually open up the laptop here. There are 13 screws on the back which you can easily unscrew, and I haven't actually taken a look inside here yet. So this is all live currently, and oh my god, the battery is massive. Holy, I wasn't expecting this thing to be this massive. Oh my god. Speakers on the left and right side, of course. little heatsink for the CPU there. SSD is here, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module probably, is this little thing here. Yeah, there's not much else to see. As it seems, you can't upgrade the RAM on this thing, but 8 GB should be enough, to be honest. 250 GB SSD, this thing varies depending on the configuration you're going to get. Because they have a website where you can configure this thing for yourself, and you can choose how much capacity of the SSD you want, which operating system, and just stuff like that. So yeah, pretty basic in the inside here, so nothing else to see here, I think. Another thing I want to show is how quickly this thing actually boots. I mean, this is on Windows 10, and when it came with Linux pre-installed, it was actually quite as fast as this, if not even if 1 or 2 seconds faster. So let me show you. I'll press the power button right now, and it's done. So let me log in to show that it's actually really fast, and there we go. This is how fast this thing really is. Even while using this thing, there were no lags or anything like that, and it's just a pleasure to use, to be honest. Let's actually talk a little bit about the software and hardware right now. This thing features an i5-7Y54 CPU clocked at 1.2 GHz, which is okay for office work, but not really for gaming, because I'll show a few games here on screen while I'm talking. And it also features an Intel HD Graphics 615 integrated GPU, which is not really great for gaming, but for light stuff like Team Fortress 2 or Portal 2, which I'll show on screen right now, it's perfectly fine. So you get around 30 to 40 FPS on Portal 2, maybe with the occasional 50 frames per second. And on Team Fortress 2, it's a little bit lower at around 30 frames per second, which is kind of okay-ish, but if there's a lot of action going on, it's not going to work anymore. Both games were set to their minimum settings in regards to graphics, and it still didn't run perfectly well. But this thing is not a gaming laptop, it's just something I was curious about to just try out. Office, of course, works without any problems. Word is a pleasure to use with this keyboard, even though it's a little bit of a weird plastic. Perfectly capable of Word, Excel, PowerPoint, everything you can imagine when it comes to office work. I've also tried to watch 4K 60fps videos on this thing, and it worked flawlessly on Windows. However, on Linux, which it came pre-installed with, it didn't work quite well. The video was dropping frames all over the place. It just didn't work at all, and it wasn't nice to watch. On Windows, however, it works flawless. On Chrome, there's a little bit of an issue. It's a Chrome-related one, not a hardware-related one. The video starts to stutter or lag behind when you're watching the video in full screen. On Edge, it works perfectly fine. So there's no issue there, and it's not an issue with the Infinity Book 14 itself. It's just an issue with Chrome, which they weren't able to fix till today. So not sure what's going on there. The next thing I want to talk about is battery life, and according to their website, you can use this thing up to 12 hours for productive work. I kind of stressed this thing while testing, benchmarking and everything, and I got around 7 to 8 hours or something like that, and it's quite impressive actually for such a thing. As we saw earlier, the battery in this thing is massive, so it's kind of expected to last this long, so no issues whatsoever there. And the last thing I want to show off is, of course, the unboxing of this thing. When we open up the top, we can see that they've included a Tuxedo Computers branded mousepad, which is actually a pretty decent quality. It's not made out of plastic, it's made out of fabric, and you can use it if you want, but I'll just give it to the side here. Under there, we can find the Infinity Book 14 itself, which I've explained earlier already in this video, so I don't have to talk about it anymore. Under that, we can find a little instruction sheet. You can read it if you want, you can put it to the side if you don't need it. But it basically just explains the Infinity Book 14 a little, and what you can do with it, and stuff like that. And they're actually nice enough to include a few adapters, like this micro HDMI to full size HDMI, because this laptop only has a micro HDMI connector. So you'll probably need it if you want to connect any HDMI device to it. Another nice addition is that they've included a USB-C to USB 3 hub, And on the top it also includes a little LAN adapter. The next thing they include is a little calendar for 2018. I don't really have a use for that because I use Google Calendar, but if you want to use that, then go ahead. And they've also included two pens here, but I think that's kind of not meant to be. I think they just wanted to include one there, but I mean, who wouldn't want a free pen anyway? So yeah. The next thing in this package is a little USB stick with the Linux image that it originally came with. There are no drivers on there, it's just the Linux installation, which will completely reset this thing to zero if you decided to reinstall something else. And it's a nice addition because they have some customizations done to the Linux distribution they actually install, and it's just nice to have. So if you ever need that, it's there. There's a little credit card thingy from Tuxedo themselves with support number and everything else you'll need to contact them. And here's a little description of the Infinity Book 14 itself. And on the right side here, we can find the charger unit for the laptop itself. And on the left side, of course, the cable which goes to the wall outlet. So this concludes my review for the Tuxedo Infinity Book 14, and I have to say I quite enjoy using this device. The build quality is superb, there are no drawbacks there whatsoever. The display is awesome, it's the best one I've used on a laptop so far, and the battery life is great. It's not extremely over the top, depends on your workload of course, but for normal office work this thing will go through a day without any problems. I can recommend it, the price isn't too high. I don't want to mention the price in this video right now because it may go down in the future. And if you're watching this video in the future somewhere, just go and check the link in the description for this exact configuration I've got here. So you can configure the device yourself a little, like the SSD and stuff like that, the SSD size. There aren't many options, but at least you can configure it like you want. My final words here are, I have no real complaints other than the keyboard having a weird plastic and the all-in-one touchpad, which is just my opinion, not a problem itself with the notebook. Yeah, I can definitely recommend this thing. Thank you for watching, leave a like if you like this video, leave a subscribe if you super like this video, or the thumbs up button of course works too, so I can see if you enjoy this video or not. Leave a comment if you have any questions and I'll try to answer them of course, and I'll see you in the next one.